Community at LACI. Oh, thank you so much, Ann. Welcome everybody to our demo day and graduation for LACI's 2021 Middle School Girls in STEM program. We are so, so thrilled to welcome you all. I'm going to share my screen and we can get our program started. Okay. Terrific. So in terms of an agenda for this afternoon, we will have some opening remarks. I will give a quick overview about our Middle School Girls in STEM program for those of you who are learning about it for the first time. We will do acknowledgements recognizing everybody who made this program possible. And then the bulk of our time in this demo day is learning and hearing from our girls about their group design challenge presentations. Once the presentations are complete, we will come back and do certificate presentations and graduate all of the girls from our program. And then finally, we wanna make sure all of the girls have warm handoffs to additional opportunities. So we'll do an introduction to additional resources and programs, and then we will close up with wrap up and next steps. So to kick us off this afternoon, we are thrilled to welcome Matt Peterson, LACI's president and CEO, to give us some opening remarks. Matt, would you like to come to the stage?
Thank you, Estelle. And I don't want to take too much of your time because we really are just excited to hear from you all, your ideas and the incredible work that you've done based on this design challenge and solution we asked you to think about. And I would just say, you know, the largest source of air pollution that affects our lungs and our health, particularly the young and the old, the most in Los Angeles is from diesel pollution, which comes from buses and trucks and other types of equipment that run on that fuel. And we really need to focus on how we particularly get the trucks and buses off the road to be zero emissions so that we can all breathe healthier air. We had some really, really poor air quality recently, partially because we have more trucks picking up the containers full of goods, some of which are holiday presents for so many people in those containers. They add additional pollution, particularly in the communities that surround those freeways, and just the same thing that, you know, when those buses pull up to your school, they're putting pollution out, and so how do we make that shift? And there's thankfully for the leadership of President Biden and Vice President Harris, there's funding in the recently passed infrastructure package that's going to help move to zero emission buses. And I really want to have your ideas presented to the LAUSD school board and others for them to be inspired to go faster, to make a full commitment and go faster in transitioning to zero emission buses, which LACI will be happy to help them with in any way we can. And so I just want to thank you for what you've done, to the teachers, for your support of these young women. I hope someday that the next Elon Musk is one of you who takes a different approach to how we need to approach the world, and maybe not as catty and more thoughtful and supportive of everybody, but, you know, just as brilliant and game changing. And so I just want to thank you all. You inspire me, and it's the reason why I get up every morning and do the work I do. Is to see emerging leaders like yourself come to the fore with your ideas that can influence not just your school, but this whole region and therefore the world. So thanks to the LACI team, thanks to Fred Rosen and all of our sponsors. I'm really just grateful to you all. Back to you, Estelle.
Wonderful. Thank you so much, Matt. Really appreciate you grounding our celebration today in a great way to honor all of our incredible teachers and girls for all the hard work that they put into this program, and excited for all the things to come as a result of their designs. As Matt had mentioned, we want to take some time to acknowledge our incredible funders without whom this program would not be possible. So big shout out to Bob Boston Scientific Foundation. Thank you so much for not only providing financial support, but also engaging your employees as mentors. Mr. Fred Rosen, who is graciously joined us here this afternoon, thank you so much for not only funding our program, but also inspiring this year's design challenge focused on electric school buses. Royal Business Bank, we are so grateful for your support and look forward to deepening our collaboration together. And special thanks to Binuri, who I know has joined us this afternoon. And last but not least, Water and Power Community Credit Union, or WPCCU. Thank you so much for covering the hard costs of our program and also serving as a mentor. So with that, I'd actually love to invite Delaine Valencia from WPCCU up to the stage to share some remarks.
Hi, Estelle. Hi, everybody. It's so great to be with you all today. And the fact that we've made it to this wonderful day, all the hard work that we poured into this. And I just so enjoyed being part of the mentor program with Vox Collegiate is who I was helping to inspire. And we're just so thrilled to be part of such a great program the second year, and the cohort was so amazing. We had great girls. I'm so proud of all of you and all of the hard work that we're going to pour into the presentations today. We're just so excited to see you all. And the credit union is just one way that we love working with LACI and the great team behind everything. The program is excellent. We love being a part of these amazing programs that are really going to be infused into real things that are going to come into fruition and, you know, electric school buses, solar, what have you. This is just such a great part of what we can contribute to. And the fact that I volunteered my time to these girls and their ideas, inspiration, brainstorm. I just know that we're going to get some great ideas and we're going to get some clean air and zero emissions into our city. So thank you for your time that you allotted me to speak. And I just cannot wait to hear everyone's presentation. So good luck to everybody today. We're rooting for you.
Fabulous. Thank you so much, Delaine. And also big shout out to Delaine, because you all may get some additional graduation gifts from WPCCU. So thank you so much, Delaine, for making that possible. I'm sure all of our girls are going to love everything you provide to them.
Thank you. Thank you for the opportunity. And girls, enjoy once you get your goodies. We can't wait till you get them.
Absolutely. Thank you so much, Delaine.
Thanks, Estelle.
Also, before we dive into the content, just wanted to lay the foundation, especially for those who are learning about our middle school girls in STEM program for the first time, what it is. So the focus of our program is to build out a pipeline for future women innovators in the STEM and sustainability space, and really create a pipeline for future women innovators to engage in our LACI programming. Our goal is to spark, light a spark for middle school girls to learn more about sustainability challenges at a young age and find their agency as problem solvers. The goal of the program is to engage girls through hands-on prototype development to address real-world challenges, community engagement, and ultimately solutions for global climate change. This year, this is the second time we're running the program. It was a 10-week hybrid program where the teachers were engaging directly with the girls in their classrooms, and then we were engaging with them virtually over Zoom. We were able to engage 3 schools this year and reach 34 girls, which we're super excited about. And this is a snapshot of our timeline. So over the summer, we worked on finalizing the program design and school and teacher recruitment. in October, November, we had launched the program. The teachers then taught the curriculum at their respective schools. The girls all worked on their prototype design, and we brought along mentors along the way to help provide additional guidance and support. And then finally, here we are in December, a demo day, where the girls are showcasing their presentations and graduating from the program, and we'll do some program evaluation. Here on the bottom left, you'll see a photo. It didn't seem so long ago, but this was the very first time we all gathered together as a group. This was our career exploration day to kick off the program. And here we are at the bookend on demo day. And then just, we included a quote from one of our participants from last year, Kelly Ocampo, who shared, you know, this program was different because we all invented something that will someday help our planet. I also would be remiss if I did not acknowledge our incredible program team, who, without whom this program would not be taking place. So big shout out to Katie Clemenson, our curriculum designer and founder of Intrepid Schools, Sharon Sagato, our workforce development manager at LACI, and Cindy Zhang, one of our awesome volunteers at LACI as well. Thank you so much, Dream Team. So grateful to be working on this incredible work alongside all of you. And with that, I'll hand it over to Sharon to acknowledge all of our mentors.
Awesome. Thank you so much, Estelle. So as Estelle had mentioned, these amazing mentors volunteered to sign up. They signed up to volunteer to help the girls throughout the program. So they helped them with everything from ideation to product and prototype development, all the way to preparing them for their final presentation today. So we'd like to personally thank Margot Randolph from Create Ventures, Delaine Valencia from WPCCU, Carrie Leslie from Verity, LACI's very own Brenda Solario, Laura Gonzalez, Adriana Embis, Molly Crete, and Cindy Zhang, who is our LACI volunteer. And last but not least, from Boston Scientific, Nupur Pandey, Jessica Block, Sarah Malik, Kaylin Bailey, and Michael Miller. As their mentors, you made a huge impact on these students to help them become the next future leaders in STEM. And also, the success of this program wouldn't have been possible without our guest speakers who came to each mentor session, and they were pretty much industry experts. So huge thank you to Ryan from Green Power Motor Company, Jerry from Tritium, Justin from Wave, and Sasha from LACI. With that, I'm gonna hand it over to Katie to talk about the schools we partnered with.
Thanks so much, Sharon. So as part of the program this year, we were able to partner with three schools, Vox Collegiate, led by Ms. Wigmore, Hollenbeck Middle School, led by Ms. Clanfer and Ms. Davenport, and Edwin Markham Middle School, led by Ms. Hunt. None of this would have been possible without our teachers. They put in time, extra time in their week since we started in September with them, and mentored the girls throughout the entire process. And so they are truly wonderful to work with. The next, we have some love from students. Feel free to throw in more shout outs for your teachers here. As you can see, this was from our pre-survey at the beginning of the program, and the students were already so excited and communicating the impact their teachers had, especially this year, coming through after your virtual school. This was such a wonderful way to reground students in community and learning, and especially within the context of STEM, and our teachers made that possible. As you can see, our big quote, you're really making a difference for us and the whole world. Thank you so much for all of this. Quotes like this just resounded throughout our surveys. So we cannot thank them enough. You want to jump to the next slide? Awesome. We also wanted to give teachers a chance to shout out their students. And so we'll just kick it off with Ms. Wigmore, if you want to jump in and shout out your students real quickly.
Sure, I'd love to shout out my students. It's really exciting because this is my first year partaking in this. And some of the students that I was working with did participate last year. So it was a learning experience for me as well. And also just with eighth grade science education, we've been learning a whole bunch of different things about just like eco-friendly things. So it was a really, really great time to brainstorm with each other. I also just have to shout out the students because their ideas were phenomenal. so creative. Their hearts were in it, and it was just a joy to be able to work with them and hear all of their thoughts.
Thank you so much, Ms. Wigmore. We'll jump to Ms. Davenport and Ms. Clanfer.
Okay, sure. First, I would just like to say I'm really proud of our girls and their continuous perseverance and commitment to this design project over the last 10 weeks. They've spent a lot of time engaging in that. Just overall, it's been really inspiring watching them tackle a real life relatable problem that happens in their communities. Our girls live in Boyle Heights, and so they've had the opportunity to really like engage in the engineering design process. And it's been a real pleasure being able to see just their imagination grow and their ideas that they came up with like come to fruition. So I'm just really proud of them and all their hard work and their creativity. Thanks. Ms. Clanfer wants to add to that.
Hi, everybody. Sorry, Ms. Clanfer here. I have the girls behind me. I know I'm in this virtual world. I am super proud of them. I mean, dedication, to say the least. The fact that, you know, we're coming back out of virtual education, meeting in place, and then having them spend that extra hour to 2 hours to at least 3 hours these past couple of weeks, every day after school, you know, texting their parents, can I stay a little bit longer, Zooming when we couldn't meet, because especially yesterday because of the rain. I mean, these girls are super dedicated. And what I'm really proud of is that they've developed this collective with each other where they understand that science looks like a girl from Boyle Heights. Science looks like a girl from Watts, from South Central. And I think that's very empowering, because if you are a woman and you're a woman in color and you majored in STEM or you continue that STEM career, we know as women of color, and especially from the inner city, that it's really lonely. It is a lonely place to be as a woman of color. And so they have now, at least, sorry, I'm getting all emotional. It's a long week for teachers, by the way. They have 9 women, young women, that they can look to if they continue this career. And that's very powerful, because I think when I was in school, that I didn't have many women I could look to, women of color who were pursuing STEM. So that's really the passion that I have here, is making sure that they see themselves reflected in the science that they're doing. And having the mentors who've mentored them was absolutely life-changing, empowering, and they could see themselves in these careers. And I think that's what's powerful, because our communities are the ones that suffer the most when it does come to climate change. So I'm really proud of the girls for sure. Sorry, it's week 50, or it's the last week of school, so it's emotional too.
Thank you so much, Ms. Davenport and Ms. Clanfer. And last but not least, Ms. Hunt, if you would like to come off mute and share.
Definitely. Ditto to everything that all of the other ladies have said. This has really been a really honor to have worked with the students here at Markham Middle School. They're so talented. They're so smart. They're all gifted. And I can see that they have bright futures ahead of them. And it's just been so wonderful, LACI, to have given us an opportunity to participate in this challenge. We see the buses that come at the front of our school every morning, the old buses, the old diesel buses that are taking students to charters and to schools outside of the Watts area. And we would love to see some of the electric buses purchased by LAUSD. And hopefully some of this information that the girls have, models that the girls, the prototypes that all of the girls have made and presented, will somehow get to those folks who make the decisions about purchasing buses for our system. So thank you, everybody. I really enjoyed working with the girls. Yeah, it's been a long 10 weeks, but they put in a lot of time, as the other ladies have said, a lot of extra time when they have a lot of work to do in their programs. So I really do appreciate them, thank them, and look forward to them being great scientists.
Thank you so much, Ms. Hunt. Yes, absolutely. As you can all see, teachers are huge catalysts for change, and I can't wait for our students to get to share the amazing work that they've been doing. So without further ado, we're going to introduce the design challenge. This year, students were challenged to design and build a prototype of a zero emissions school bus. And so their task was to design an electric bus that could replace the ones currently used by LAUSD. And then the second part was to create a marketing campaign that could get LAUSD excited about transitioning to electric vehicles.
And also just another quick plug, just thank Mr. Fred Rosen for helping to inspire this year's design challenge. This was actually a perfect design challenge. A lot of our teachers gave us great feedback that the girls were so invested in it because it's directly applicable to their daily lives. So we truly appreciate it.
Absolutely. And so the order that we'll be having students present in, first we'll have Vox Collegiate, then Markham, and then Hollenbeck. Each school will have 10 minutes to present, and then followed by 3 minutes for Q&A. As the students present, we strongly encourage everyone to throw in shout outs, call out new things you're excited about, ask questions, and do this all throughout the presentation. And so that way, when students are done presenting, they have a ton of love in the chat they can look to, and then we'll get to answering your questions. One moment while I share. All right, Team Vox, you have the floor.
Okay, thank you, Ms. Clemenson. Should we just say next slide when we're ready, or?
Yep. I'll pay attention to you and try to anticipate, but yes.
Awesome. Okay, well then we will begin.
Welcome to our Vox Collegian Solar Buses presented by us, the Vox STEM Club. This more, but okay, so we can move on to the next slide. Okay, so here's the problem. According to the California Air Resources Board in California, about 1 in 8 children take a school bus between home and school. The community contributes 33% of a child's daily exposure to some air pollutants. The diesel exposure was up to 2.5 times higher when windows were closed. LA has heavy traffic and the high amount of pollutants occur, especially when traffic is heavy. Due to the condition of our planet with climate change, we do not want gas-powered buses. Our solution is we want students taking the bus to not be exposed to the air pollutants and the billions of carbon dioxide fumes that come from buses. With our design, we aim to reduce school bus related exposures by creating the cleanest buses we can envision. This is why we decided to create a bus that can run on renewable energy. We have created a bus that can use the sun's solar energy to power its travel. In LA, the sun shines most of the day. Therefore, we think this is a profitable and clean renewable energy source. What we took into consideration is solar powered buses do not release as much fossil fuel. It will reduce the toxins and pollution in our air. Cleaner air, what does this bus space look like? We want to ensure the safety of the students first. The size of solar panels. Okay, so this, the steps of our design. So these are a bunch of pictures we added, like just for decor. But we could go move on to the next slide. Okay, so at the beginning, we had a lot of ideas about how the design should look. That was a very intriguing part for us. We collaborated a lot on the whiteboard. That was our thinking stage. We learned about solar-powered cars and science, so that gave us the idea for solar-powered buses. There was discussions about where the solar panels should go, how to charge the solar panels, if we should use a battery or motor, the size of the bus, the design of the bus, how it ran, the reason behind solar energy, et cetera. Through group discussions and meetings with our mentors, we collaborated on ideas and best and results.
So, We went from many ideas for our syllabus. In the beginning, we of trying to see what we wanted to add to our syllabus, we had many ideas, but only some come through. Although not all of our ideas were put in, all of our thoughts were put into consideration for how to make our syllabus the best for students. We have been seeing multiple ways to make our syllabus the best for students, and that was what we had so far.
Yeah.
So this was just a more, let's call it, like, more in-depth presentation of the last idea. So, like, with more GPS, the charging stations, and including what we needed.
Yeah.
The point of the diagrams are to get an idea of what we want to make our bus look like and how it runs. We didn't want to jumpstart without that. This was our fresh design of our syllabus. We have improved so much from before. Oh, okay. So me and another member, we made another diagram of a more in-depth, like the final drawing. And this is what we came up with. We're just gonna, this is the 3D model. Yeah, quarters. And this is our makeup idea of a solar panel. The school buses will recharge through the solar panels, or when it's nighttime, the chargers that were made for the buses can charge them. We plan to have charging stations and garages throughout Los Angeles. Yeah, we already showed them. Again.
Hello. Hello, key features. Our solar buses have cells on the roofs. On the roofs, solar panels, which convert the sun's energy into electric energy, then that can start our engine. Our engine is a push start feature. Our panels will provide 700 kW of electricity. The buses can travel up to 300 miles a day. The electric bus batteries get their energy from the solar energy of the sun. Our bus will have a solar panel covered bus station, which looks like this kind of. Because solar powered bus services involve recharging the bus from solar energy, this is where the battery pack recharges and then is plugged into the bus. This sets our buses apart from others in LA. This sets our bus apart from others in LA because it runs on solar energy, which means it powered by the energy that the sun produces. There will be also solar power stations. So when the sun sets, the solar power stations will be able to recharge the solar buses.
Students will benefit from this change and design because they can get home in a safer way and safer than walking from school. This change can benefit students into getting home earlier from school, because sometimes walking can slow them down to get home and it gets dark soon. The change will benefit students also our ecosystem, because it will reproduce the gases and their release into the air.
Why is this necessary? Solar vehicles produce a lower amount of greenhouse gas emissions than diesel. The bus obtains solar energy by using solar panels on the surface of the bus and therefore converts it into electrical energy. The best part is there isn't fuel cost. They run on sunlight. There are significant benefits of solar cars to the environment, such as minimal release of exhaust fumes and greenhouse gases in our atmosphere. Okay, why we are passionate about this? A really big incentive is it will reduce approximately 6 tons of oxygenated and 160 carbon dioxide emissions. Reduces the toxins and pollution in our air. Cleaner air, it will help our climate because the amount of exhaust will not be as great. Therefore, the limit on carbon dioxide heating up our planet will be less and less. It is using renewable energy. The bus can reach a full charge in around 6 to 8 hours.
Our different features. It is not like any other bus, but it burns less fuel because it runs on sunlight energy. The design is not a kind of other classic school buses. It starts on push start. The solar energy converts the energy in the battery pack. And once the battery pack is changed, it can run. Also used for backup power. Sun is the power of solar. With the sun is also renewable.
Oh, thank you. We hope you enjoy our solar lesson.
Thank you. God bless you.
Hi.
Come on. No. Oh. Oh. You guys have any questions?
Good team. We're girls.
Thank
you. So good. Thank you.
Do you want to say tomorrow?
Oh, good job. Amazing. Great work. Great work. Any questions?
No question.
The first ones to present. Thank you. What's way to go through the enjoy of the teamwork and so much out of you. Thank you.
Thank you so
you
much.
Shout
God
out to us. That was
fantastic. No.
Stay healthy.
Okay.
God bless you.
Make sure you guys wear your mask.
Does anyone have any questions for Team Talk? Feel free to come off mute or drop it into the chat if you have any questions. Otherwise, ladies, please enjoy reading all of the amazing shout outs in the chat. Bill Beverly asks, have you thought of a name for your bus?
Oh, the name for the bus.
It was a safe place.
It's a safe place.
Yeah. For like a sacred air community type.
Sacred area, sacred place with people.
Like the design was like just for the outside, but the actual thought, the engineering that went into it, it's like makes the air safer.
No pollution.
Wonderful. Any other questions for Team Vox? All right, well, if you have any come up, please feel free to throw them in the chat. Shout out again to all the students and Team Vox. I mean, they're presenting as a team virtually with like their 3D models. And it's just, you know, it's really fun. I think the average age of participants is 13 years old. And this is what they're doing here in front of such a large audience. And so just a ton of love I love all of the confidence that you all were speaking with. Great way to kick us off. On deck, we have Markham Middle School. And so Markham, if you want to get ready to present, I will pull up your slides right now. All right, Markham, you have the floor.
This is our presentation made by the girls of Markham. Presenting Zero Emissions Transportation Challenge. Each year, diesel school buses emit an average of 27.1 tons of greenhouse gases into the surrounding environment. Pollution is increasing day by day, and that is affecting our atmosphere. If we don't change our pollution habits soon, we are going to destroy our own planet and environment. It impacts air pollution, respiratory illnesses, and climate change. Our design challenge was to design a zero emissions bus for our school. Presenting the Blooming Engineers representing Markham Middle School. Our group is starting off with Samantha Mendez, who will be a future veterinarian or lawyer, Latiana Wilson, a future pediatrician, Kayla Sanchez, a future writer or psychiatrist, Kima Azam, a future chemist, Allison Solares, a future aerospace engineer or oncologist, or a radio host. Alison Cardenas is still deciding, but I know she will get there soon. Lindsay Hernandez will be a future dentist, and Victoria Calixto, a future lawyer or artist. Passing it off to Samantha Mendez with our design thinking process.
Our design thinking process. Step one, ask, understand the problem. Step two, imagine, brainstorm solutions. Step three, plan. Step four, create, make and test a prototype. Step five, improve, refine. Our design thinking process and action. Our first idea was to build an electric school bus prototype with Play-Doh as the exterior. We realized that didn't work when we saw the Play-Doh would harden too fast before we got to mold it to the shape we wanted to. Next, we tried to make a prototype out of construction paper and the base we already had. Now we have a prototype with a proper exterior. We also have a charging station for the bus.
On slide 10,
and Kima Azam.
I'm sorry about that. On slide 10, you can see where the emergency exits are located. To the top left corner of the page, showing two roof hatches, two emergency windows, the rear exit, the side door, for storage, the storage compartments. To the right, you can see the battery is located in the back top left corner from my left. And the adapters are one in the back or behind the battery and two in the front. On the bottom of the page, you can see the system controller represented as a square box and the rectangular box as the auxiliary controller. To elaborate, the SC manages commands or regulates the behavior of other devices or systems using controller loops, while the AC is a physical controller that can be programmed to control the ISO bus implement, which assigns the functions. Next slide, please. In this bus diagram, you can see where the side windows are located, where the door, how the door is designed. And if you look closely in the back, it says the door for wheelchairs. In the front of the bus, I designed the windows to be wide so that the students and the drivers are able to see clearly outside of their surroundings. And then in the back, I drew the stop sign in the back of the bus so that other drivers and other people can see to stop when the bus is coming or passing through. And you can also see the where the charger is.
It harnesses the energy from the cable box, which is the electric grid. The cable box is connected to the charging station that gives the energy to charge the bus.
As you see here, you can see that the Play-Doh exterior didn't work out because it dried out too fast, as in the previous slides. And on the in the next picture, you can see how our charging station was in progress.
Why should LAUSD District buy our electric school bus? Why should LAUSD District buy our innovative electric school bus? Well, our electric school bus will have 90 seats, a tracker, emergency buttons, and an overall safer environment. But how will this help the environment become safe to become safer? We know that one of the reasons that there is so much pollution in the air is because of diesel fuel. By purchasing our bus, LAUSD will be able to reduce pollution. Now that we have seen a benefit for the environment, what's the benefit for the students? The students will be able to benefit from the bus because of the new comfortable chairs. The new chairs will help students improve posture while still being comfortable. Additionally, they will benefit from the clean air and a pull-down table to finish work or just have fun. Price. The average diesel school bus cost is from $90,000 to $290,000. For our bus, we wanted to make it less than that so it could be more affordable. We wanted to make an electric school bus affordable so that more people buy our school bus and less pollution is emitted. If the price is unreasonably too high, then not many people would want to purchase it. So to actually be able to make a difference, our total cost for one bus would be $197,000. This would save a school bus an average amount of $93,000.
key features of our electric school bus, tablet and app. The reason for adding a tablet is for the bus driver to drive with more safety. The app would have a tracking device that will alert and tell parents how far their kids are from their school.
Bus shape. The bus has an aerodynamic shape. This will make it easy to tell apart, and it's going to work better than most buses. Battery location. Battery location would be a key feature to the bus because this will be something that makes it unique from other buses. The location of the battery will be on the back of the bus.
The bus will have 3 to 4 emergency buttons at the front, middle, and back. Just in case something happens, adults will be alerted.
The charging station is powered by an electric grid. The electric grid then connects to the charger, which then would connect to the bus.
The screen to activate. The screen to activate the charging station is on the machine that you plug the charger in.
Sorry, the slide moved on its own.
Here you can see the finished prototype of what the electric school bus would look like. And we're also getting prepared to show you a live version of all the
This is the final product of the charging station. The charging station was made by me and Addison Carter.
I think you said you wanted to share a live version. I'll stop sharing my screen so you can.
We have a little technical issue. If you can just give us a few minutes.
No problem. In the meantime, if anyone wants to throw shout outs into the chat, include other students, mentors, anybody on the call, or any questions you have for Team Markham while they prepare to give us a live demo of their prototype. Thank you so much, ladies. It was very exciting. I loved how dynamic it was. We saw drawings, we saw built prototypes. And I'm really excited to see what you all have, especially the data. Always get excited with data.
I can't believe they had a life-size prototype. Kudos to you, Markham. That was great. Excellent work, students.
Wonderful. So much love for y'all in the chat, Team Markham. Just let me know when you're ready.
We're ready.
Wonderful. Do you want me to bring the slides back up?
No, we don't need the slides right now.
Awesome. Go for it.
As you see in live audio or video, I should say, you can see that the windows are wide enough for the students to see. We used recyclable eye lenses for our windows. We glued them with hot glue gun. The exterior of the bus is made out of construction paper, and you can see that the shape of our bus is aerodynamic. Inside, you can kind of see a little bit our driver who's waving, and the students in the back. The seats are curved in a way to where they're able to lean back, but also have good posture, like in the slides. And you can see how the charging station and the bus work together. The bus is able to back up into the bus, and the driver is able to get out and just plug the bus in with the charger, like what you do with your phone.
You all really made it look life size. I thought it was as big as a person. We were able to see the proportions with the water bottle, though. That's great.
Thank you.
Wow, that was fantastic, Marco. Definitely check out the chat. There's so much love for you in there. Any questions before we move on to our third and final presentation? All right, Team Hollenbeck, y'all are on deck. I will pull up your slides now. All right, Team Hollenbeck, you have the floor.
Hi, everyone. This is just pictures of the teachers. So Ms. Davenport and I, and if you click through a couple of slides, you just see pictures of them working. So designing, meeting in Zoom, eating pizza, having a good time. And now they'll be ready to present. Thank you.
Hi, my name is Natalie Avalar, and I'm an eighth grader at Hollenbeck LPS Magnet.
Hi, my name is Jillian Gutierrez, and I'm an eighth grader at Hollenbeck.
Hello, my name is Giselle Avila, and I'm an eighth grader at Hollenbeck LPS Magnet. Together with our seventh grade teammates, we are the Boyle Heights Zero Emission Vehicle Girls, better known as the ZEV Girls. Now, Jocelyn will introduce you to our design prototype.
Hello all, I'm Jocelyn, and I would like to show you guys our innovative bus and tell you some of the features that it has. Our innovative bus, the ZEV bus, titled the Clean Ride for Kids, is cool bus, and we would like to introduce you to it because it has a few amazing features. Bus has features for tracking your child to and from school so that you can know when your child arrived at school. The app developer team made that. I would also like to tell you guys about the fact that our bus is run solar energy. It's run on solar and wind energy. Our bus is really cool because I froze up.
Next slide, please.
We will continue this presentation by explaining our design process for our bus prototype. The problem what we set out to solve is to design a zero emission school bus for our school district. This is important because, as we mentioned earlier, each year diesel buses emit a ton of pollution in the communities that we live in, like Boyle Heights. This is important because our school district currently uses diesel buses that emit fuels into our communities. Here are the pictures of our first individual drafts to address the problem.
We realized that our individual drafts needed to be combined together in order to form groups based on common interests, the outside of the bus, the inside of the bus, and an app for the bus. As a result, we worked together as a team to develop one electric bus design using all of our collective ideas together. This is our first draft.
Next, we met with our engineer mentors and they gave us feedback to refine our prototype design. We also used feedback from each other. For our external group, a piece of feedback that we received was to move the battery from underneath the bus to the back of the bus. For our internal group, one piece of feedback that we received when we met with the engineers was to change our original charging ports from cords to charge pads. Lastly, for our app group, it was recommended that we chose 3 to 4 key parts of the app to focus on and consider adding security checks when students log into our app. Next, we will show you our refined prototype solutions based on the feedback we received.
Based on feedback from our mentors and what we have learned from our engineering presentations, we were able to create better prototypes. Each team worked together. These are some of the drafts that the teams have worked on. Each team will present what they've made, and we'll now discuss the details, starting with our external bus team.
Hello all, I'm Jennifer Hernandez Ortega, a seventh grader at Hollenbeck Middle School. Hello all, I'm Jennifer Hernandez Ortega, a seventh grader at Hollenbeck Middle School. I am here to talk about some key features of the external parts of our bus. Some of the key features on the outside of our electric bus are: our bus includes solar panels on the top of the bus, as wind turbines on the side of the bus. Our charging stations are powered by solar and wind energy. Our battery in the bus and in the charging stations lasts 15 years, and the buses last for decades. When designing the outside of our electric bus,
We took into consideration using clean energy sources so our buses do not cause pollution. Our bus is free of fossil fuels. The bus will last for decades to come. The battery lasts for a minimum of 12 years, which is the time it takes a student to graduate from high school.
Our bus design solves the problem of pollution caused by diesel buses by using clean energy. The solar panels on top of the bus gets radiant energy from the sun and converts that into electricity, which can then be used to power the bus and make the bus move. Energy can also be stored in the batteries. Our batteries are located in the back of the bus. We also use wind energy. Wind energy is gathered by the little wind turbines on the top of the bus. The top of the bus gathers wind energy and kinetic energy from the fans of the bus and converts that into electricity, which helps the bus power. We added this feature to make sure that students can still get to school in the winter months when there's less sunlight, so we can still go to school even though there might not be a lot of sun to charge the buses. And the bus will run on solar energy. Our buses will be powered along the ride and will be charged overnight. It has
Jasmine, I think you're muted. Are you still talking?
Design solves the problem caused by pollution by using clean energy. Our bus design solves the problem of pollution caused by diesel buses by using clean energy. Our buses have solar panels and have the ability to use wind energy. The bus runs on wind and solar energy. The bus collects wind energy from the panels on top of the fan and from the top of the bus and on the top of the charging station. Our bus can be powered by solar energy. The way it's powered by solar energy is because it collects sunlight from the top of the solar panels and converts that into energy, which can then be stored or used in the bus. And our batteries will be located at the back. We have turbines that spin and the wind gives it kinetic energy, and turned into electricity and can then be used to power and move the bus. We added the wind energy thing for like to cover the winter month, because you know when students have to go to school in the winter or like in the cold months. Well, we added that so that they won't have to go to school like walking, so that they can still take the bus. And since there's less sunlight, the bus will still be able to power through, you know, wind energy.
Here is an aerial view of our electric bus design. As you can see, we have our battery at the back of the bus and solar panels at the top of the bus and our windmills along the side of the bus. I would like to share with you our 3D prototype models. Here are our 3D prototypes that show our design. As you can see, our charging station has solar panels at the top and windmills. Both features are used to gather clean energy, sun and wind, from our Los Angeles environment. A charging station can comfortably charge 4 buses at a time.
We were tasked with only using classroom materials and consumables from bags sent from LACI to build our 3D prototypes. We used cardboard for the bus and construction paper for the panels on the bus. We also used styrofoam cups to build the pillars and hold up the charging station. We also used note cards, brads, and straws to build the wind turbines. Finally, we used discarded wires to create the charging station plug.
Here is a close-up picture of our 3D prototype, which shows features such as the charging port, the solar panels, the battery, and the windmill, which is all connected together to charge our electric bus. Here is an up-close picture of our prototype, which shows how the charging port connects to our bus. This allows the bus to charge overnight from all the energy gathered from the solar and wind turbines. Thank you, and now you will hear from our ZEB internal team.
Hello, my name is Sophia Cabada, and I'm a 7th grader at Hollenbeck LPS Magnet.
Hello, my name is Melanie Arroyo, and I am a 7th grader at Hollenbeck, and we are the team in charge of inside features of the bus.
Hi, my name is Kayla Rodriguez, and I am a 7th grader at Hollenbeck LPS Magnet, and we are the SEV internal features team. Here are the key features on the inside of our SEV bus. We decided on including softer, more comfortable bus seats, especially for students having a long bus ride. We also included a fold-out table for students to complete homework, read, draw, or place any items or snacks they want. This fold-out table includes a charging pad and a charging port for students to charge their Chromebook, tablet, or phone. Our team decided to include a tablet on the back of each seat so students can use the important learning apps through the LAUSD Clear app. Finally, our bus includes Wi-Fi that students can use by logging in with their LAUSD school account. Next slide.
I would like to share with you 3D prototype models for the inside of our bus. Here are our 3D prototypes that show our design. The model on the left was our initial bus prototype. During the engineering phase of this prototype, our goal was to make our seat comfy and show the screen and drop down table.
However, after discovering we had more materials to work with, we designed a more durable seat prototype. We used cardboard boxes, construction paper, and paint. As you can see, our seat allows students to complete schoolwork on their ride to and from school and allows them to charge their devices. Now you will hear from our ZEV app team.
As a part of our ZEV design, we decided to create a software that would make our ZEV ride safe and informational. As you can see, here are the key tech features for the app we designed for our electric bus. One is being able to see your destination, searching up bus stations, a GPS system, and last but not least, we have a schedule feature. We feel that these four features are important, and we also took into consideration how parents might feel when the child gets on the bus. They would be able to track their student and know when they're going to get off the bus.
Thank you.
Our ZEFA system comes with an app feature which allows students and parents to know where the safest and more efficient transportation is and how to find it. Here we have an example of how the app would look like once the app opens on a Chromebook or a phone device, letting them have the option of signing up or logging in. This slide shows how the app would look like when someone clicks on sign up. A student or parent guardian would sign up and click sign in. And then from a parent's perspective as an app user, they would have opened a template like this one. Parents have a feature that allows them to connect to their child's school account. The app connects parents, children, siblings, and other guardians that have access to the student to log in, to the student login information. After that, they will have mapping GPS access of the bus, where it's going, and its travel time to destination. They have access to making a pass for their kids so that way they can get on the bus. The slide shows a blue mark which would symbolize the student and where a route, and there would be a route on the screen showing where the bus is going. Next up, we have schedules from a student's perspective, and the slide shows when the next bus will be arriving and if it is on time. If the bus is not on time, it shows if there are any setbacks, and under the time, it will let you know by saying things like, "We are sorry to inform you, but your bus will be delayed," or "Your bus will be something minutes late," or "Your bus has been delayed." And it would give you the opinion, the option of finding other and closer bus stations so you can get to your destination. It also shows how long it would take to get to other places, such as other schools in your school zone, and will show how to get there.
We also created a 3D prototype of our app and bracelet pass. The phone as shown in the photo is made out of cardboard, while the pass is made out of a small strip of paper. The bracelet pass is mainly made for students without a phone or a gadget in order to show their QR code instead. Our app connects with the QR code, which needs to be scanned in order to be allowed inside the bus.
In closing, we are currently working on engineering design for bus seatbelts, wheelchair access, and bike ramps. Thank you for taking time out of your day to come and listen to us. We really appreciate it. The girls and I worked hard for the past couple months trying to create cleaner transportation for our community and city. We hope you choose a ZEV zero emission vehicle for bus transportation for LACI School District. Have any questions?
Wow, that was phenomenal. I hope you all check out the chat. If anyone has any questions, please feel free to come off mute and ask Team Dev or throw it in the chat. Oh, I already see the one. Victoria asks, what happens if a student loses their bracelet? If anyone from Team Dev wants to come off mute.
I think what we thought is if they lose it, they would probably have to pay a little fee because it's a really important QR code and not anyone could just get it. They would need to be inside a school or something.
Thank you so much. Any other questions for Team Zev?
I have a question. Would the students be able, you know how you said there would be like a tablet on the back of the seats, which I thought was a really cool feature. Would students have to log in to use that tablet? Would it just be kind of anybody who sits down there could use it?
They have to.
Yes. Like normal tablets, what would happen is that it would
Okay. So what happened is that they would log into the tablets, and then it would be like how the Chrome works. There would be like different, of course, there would be different accounts used onto it. And so when you're logging onto it, you would click on which account you want to log into. And then after you're done using it, you just log out.
Thank you.
Wow, thank you all so much. Again, Team Zev, I hope you go into the chat and see there's tons of great comments for you in there. And just shout out to all three schools. The work you did was phenomenal. This is the best part of my day for sure. I hope you're all incredibly proud of yourselves, and shout out again to your teacher leaders, who led you to this point. This was fantastic. I am going to pass it over to Sharon, but everyone can feel free to keep throwing in shout outs into the chat.
Awesome.
Can I show a visual of the bus real fast?
Where?
Let me just fix the wheel. Okay, here we go. Here's the bus that we have designed. Here's the charging station we have. Right here we have charge port. Right here we have charging ports right here. And we have the back of the bus, which we didn't put on. Don't mind that. Right here we have charging ports and the little area to charge it. And that's pretty much it for the bus, but it'll be better if it was in real life. If it was a real bus.
Wow, thank you all so much for sharing that with us. Again, I really encourage all three schools, please consider sharing this with your school leaders and local leaders in your districts. I think that all three presentations were really compelling and definitely made me even more excited about electric vehicles. And so, your voices are powerful. So definitely think about continuing to share this work that you did. It's really incredible. Sharon, off to you.
Awesome. Thank you so much, Katie. Again, echoing what Katie said, congratulations. It's an amazing job to all of you guys. So as a way to kind of thank you guys for being so great and doing this program with us, we'd like to show you a certificate. So on behalf of LACI, we'd like to present to you your certificate of achievement as a STEM and sustainability innovator. So these certificates were signed by our CEO and president, Matt Peterson, as well as your teachers. So we'll be sending that out to you guys. And then also, thank you. Also, LA County's Board of Supervisors, Hilda Solis, heard about what you all were doing and wanted to present you with an additional certificate. And it reads, with sincere congratulations and best wishes, the Board of Supervisors of the County of Los Angeles does hereby join in your celebration. So we'll be dropping this off to your school so you guys can all have it hopefully in time for the holidays. Alrighty, and this is our graduating class. So from Ms. Hunt's class, we'd like to congratulate Kima Azam, Victoria Calixto, Allison Solares, Danya Heckard, Allison Cardenas, Lindsay Wilson, Kayla Sanchez, and Samantha Mendez. From Ms. Wigmore's class, we'd like to congratulate Kamani Douglas, Miracle Jackson, Brenda Nochebuena, Ashley Hernandez Braganza, Giselle Michavaria, Maria Garcia, Leia Salcedo, Valerie Escobar, Simone Ford, Allison Valle, Lamar Martin, Tamari Bridgewater, and Ureldi Cisernos. And last but not least, from Ms. Klan for Ms. Davenport's class, we'd like to congratulate Natalie Avalar, Jasleen Rodriguez, Jennifer Hernandez Ortega, Delaney Gutierrez, Kayla Rodriguez, Melanie Arroyo, Sophia Cabada, Giselle Avia, and Jaylene Martinez. Congratulations to all of you. Alrighty, and now I'm going to hand it over to Estelle to introduce additional resources and programs.
Fantastic. Thank you so much, Sharon. So as we mentioned earlier, you all did such a phenomenal job. We were super blown away by all of your creative ideas and want to encourage you all to continue to pursue, you know, additional opportunities in your STEM and sustainability journey. So we wanted to highlight two programs that are partner organizations of ours who are recruiting right now to share a little bit more about their work and encourage you all to apply if you're interested. So may I please introduce from Magenta House, we have Eugene Shirley, president of Pando Populous, as well as Amy Goldberg, producer.
Okay, Estelle, thank you very much. Sharon, wonderful to see you as well. And students, it's just absolutely wonderful to see what you're doing and to see the way you've been honored, not only by LACI, but also by the county supervisors. That's really extraordinary. So we're an organization that's totally focused on sustainability within LA County. We have a heavy focus on water and power sustainability. And we thought, you know, wouldn't it be wonderful if we could capture the energy and intelligence and creativity of middle and high school students across the city, like yourselves, and focus them on water and power sustainability over this next semester. We thought a way to do that would be to have an expo event, which would be like a science fair, but it's all oriented towards sustainability. That would happen at the end of April. And we get students together to dream up their best ideas on water and power sustainability, saving water and power, develop those ideas out, and then bring them to the expo and to showcase them. There's a $5,000 prize that would be spread among the sponsoring organizations that win at the expo. And we have thought it'd be just a great opportunity for everybody. And then to make sure that the projects, that students have all the support they need in order to get their projects developed for the expo, we thought, wouldn't it be wonderful to create what we call an accelerator experience, which essentially is what LACI is, but we would be doing it for middle school and high school students. We give them all the help they need to create really great projects with creative brainstorming opportunities, with project implementation guidance, with advisors and mentors, and a $500 budget per project. So the students would be able, would be for each team that would be going through the accelerator, so that the teams would be able to pay for the kinds of expenses that they might have in developing their projects. So that's, I just wanted to come on, use the opportunity to tell you all about it. I think you all have done an amazing job. So this is exactly the group that we would love to have involved at the expo in April and also at the accelerator, which begins in early February. My colleague Amy Goldberg is on. Amy, is there anything that you would add?
Yes, I would just like to myself say that it was wonderful to see your such well-researched and innovative projects. So thanks for including us in that. I would just speak to teachers and wanted to point out that teachers can be as involved as they wish. It can be a lightweight program for them, or they can be hands-on in any way they'd like to. It can be used as a program in its whole, in its parts. You'll see that when we send additional information to you. And all we'd really like you to do is schedule an introductory presentation from us. It'll be 30 minutes at most. That would take place in January. Encourage your students to form a team. The team can be any size, and have them attend our creative brainstorming blitz in early February. That will be an invaluable learning opportunity, and it'll be so much fun for them. We guarantee that, and for the teachers. I think you'll get a lot out of it. And then basically, you know, the students can just do it with the help that we will provide them. You can check in with them during the project implementation period. And basically, you know, the mentors will see them through, and we have templates for their presentation that they can use. And we'd love for you to join them and help them celebrate at the expo at the end of April. And that's really about it.
Fantastic. Thank you so much, Amy. Thank you so much, Eugene. Super excited with what you're doing at Magenta House. So please stay tuned, everybody. We'll send additional information about how to get more involved.
Thank you.
And of course, thank you. And also wanted to highlight our very own Katie Clemenson, founder of Intrepid Schools, with a lot of exciting opportunities for you to get engaged. So I'll hand it over to Katie.
Awesome. Thank you so much, Estelle. Can I share my screen? I can
go to the
website. It'll be easier. Okay, thank you all. So my name is Katie. I founded Intrepid Schools. So Intrepid Schools was a collaboration between students, teachers, and community leaders in 48 states and Canada. And our goal is to create and expand pathways for middle and high school students into STEM careers through real world experiences, solving challenges within their own communities. And so the immediate opportunity opening right now that all students participating in the LACI Design Challenge will have free access to is our Winter Break Design Challenge. So if you liked what you did with LACI, I would like to do a mini version. With that, you can participate as an individual, as a student team with your friends, or as a family, in which case all ages are welcome. And you'll be able to create a prototype and design a solution and share it with STEM professionals and get feedback similar to now. That's our Winter Break Design Challenge, and that will be due January 7th, which I believe is a Friday. And then on the broader scale, we have a project recently funded by the EPA, starting for the 2022-2023 school year. All three schools that participated in this if you would like to participate in the pilot, you have automatic entry because of your participation in the LACI program. And through that, you would get to do a year-long program where you design a solution to your community, specifically related to climate change and environmental justice. And so here's just a little bit about that. These are the guides that you'll receive. And here are just a few other designs that other students have created in our pilots throughout the country. And so I know we're at time, so I'll stop. But teachers, look forward to all of that information in your email. It would be just a privilege to continue working with you all and students as well. Thanks so much, Estelle.
Thank you so much, Katie. Super excited with what you've built at Intrepid. So please stay tuned for more information about how to participate in those challenges. And as Katie noted, we are at time. So I just wanted to, as we're wrapping up, just do a rapid fire final reflections. So invite you all in the chat, whether you're a student, a teacher, a mentor, a guest today, please share any one of these things, an aha, something you learned in the program or something you learned by watching the girls' presentations today, appreciation, something you appreciated today as you're watching during demo day. And then third is an aspiration, something that you are looking forward to. So I'll give everyone just a couple seconds to type something in the chat, an aha, appreciation, or aspiration. Appreciate my team, yep. Oh yeah, lots of love for your team members. And yes, looking forward to seeing what these girls come up with next. Super inspiring work. Beautiful. Appreciating the teacher leaders, organizers, appreciating the students and dedication to being innovative. Appreciate that you are all able to be here virtually or in person. Oh my gosh, look at all this love. This is fantastic. Oh my gosh. So inspired. Yes, I think we all agree. We cannot wait to see what you girls come up with next. Like if today was any indication, the future is bright for all of us because we're in your great hands. So just in closing, want to thank you all so much for your support of this event and our middle school girls in STEM program in general. In closing, here are our next steps. So our graduates, we want to learn how to continue to be better as a program. So we have a post survey for you that Katie dropped in the chat. Please spend 10 10 minutes just to provide feedback on things you like, things we can do better. And as Sharon mentioned, we'll drop off certificates and the goodies from WPCCU to your school, so you'll have them. To all of our teachers, please stay tuned for the additional resources and programs we share today. We'll send a resource kit with more links around how to get more engaged. And in terms of program wrap up, we'll also circle back with all of you with all our final steps. And to all of our guests, we are so thrilled to have all of you celebrating with us today. Thank you so much for your support. And please stay tuned for more middle school girls in STEM programming in 2022. And wishing you and your loved ones a very joyous holiday season. And with that, actually, I'd love to take a quick group photo. Can we all, if you're able to, just turn your cameras on so we can just take a quick beautiful group photo of everybody here today. You can pose whatever you would like to do. Oh my gosh, this looks fantastic. All right, everyone. Oh, look at everyone popping off on screen. All right, y'all ready? I'm gonna take two of them because we are a big group. All right, ready? One, two, three. You take one more. If you're on the other screen, hold on 1 second. Ready, one, two, three. Awesome. Thank you all so much. Congratulations, everybody. So thrilled. Katie, any announcement about post survey before we close?
Please, students, please complete the post survey right now. I'm going to drop it in the chat again. We love your feedback. It helps us make the program better, and it gives us a chance to celebrate you all even more for all the growth that you've made. So please fill it out tonight and at the very latest by Friday.
Perfect. Thank
you. Teachers, I'll also email you the link.
Awesome. Thanks so much, Katie. And Sharon's going to bring us home.
There's a girl I find. In my reflection, she is smart and kind. Don't need protection, she's a warrior. And she is waiting for you just around the bend. Where every day you're a hero, the lights of the night. Where you lead with your courage and dream.